So I will teach you, before I go into the 7, I will teach you how to basically convert your lecture note into a creative content. Okay? Follow me step by step. Give me some time. I don't want to exceed. It's around 10 o'clock, right? Give me about 15 minutes, but this is very useful for you and it will protect your lecture note. Okay? So the first thing about lecture note, as Prof. Hong mentioned, you can actually download lecture note from SlideShare, which is actually Creative Commons. I upload all my lecture on SlideShare. Every time you download, you will get a prompt on your LinkedIn account. If you are using LinkedIn account, you will get a prompt there saying you got downloads, okay? So that improves your visibility. But if you want to use the lecture note, we will show you how to do it. You need to go first to PowerPoint. You start with PowerPoint. Okay, just start with the plain PowerPoint slide. Okay, I will show you this. Assume that we are constructing a lecture, but I'm going to do only two slides. And I'll show you how to embed the license into your lecture note. Okay, just do a lecture, Taklimat, just write Taklimat Smart V3. Okay? And then you just put below, you write your CEL and UMS.video.com. Okay, I create this lecture content. Here, the Pusat. You need to insert your data into the lecture note. Okay, I'll explain to you why it's done this. Okay, now you need to create a license for this lecture. You have two options to create a license. One is you go to DPI, you fill up Borang IP3. The IP3. Have you filled up copyright anytime? Okay. So you can fill up Borang IP3, you collect all your lecture notes, you compile, you make it into a book, and you can either publish, you can print it out, or you can make an e-book and you can file for copyright. Okay, you can file for copyright. MIPO will grant you a copyright within maybe 3 months. So that becomes your copyright book of lectures, okay? So you can use it for teaching. Of course, in today's world, knowledge is always changing. We can't learn a book, right? It's so fluid knowledge. So, but you can actually protect your lecture note by using a copyright. Okay, but copywriting takes time. And copywriting requires permission from DPI. Now you need to get a license. So what you do, you go to Creative Commons. Okay, go to Creative Commons. Okay, go to a site called Creative Commons. License Chooser. Creative Commons. This is the Creative Commons. Are you all aware of Creative Commons? Yeah. So Creative Commons basically contains content deposited by other authors. It can be a photographer, it can be a researcher. This content is designed to reuse, remix, and reshare. So if there's a lecture note, if I put my lecture note on Creative Commons, anybody can download it, reuse it, and remix it, and reshare based on the license. Okay. So this is where you create your license, okay? So to create your license for the slide, we are going to go to Creative Commons and we are going to do a license chooser. Go to license chooser, creativecommons.org. You can bookmark it in your respective. So you can click license chooser. Just look for license chooser by searching. License chooser. Actually, it's easier to search through Google than the actual site because it has a lot of content. So yeah. Just say, just look for license. Just, you are. Still the donation. Everyone give one ring. Okay, I'll give you the URL. Give them the specific URL. Okay, I'll give you the URL. Copy the page. Okay, I'm going to share with you the specific URL. So it's chooser. Okay. Okay. It's https://creativecommons.org/choose. So this one is actually a license which is generated by you. It's not generated by MIPO. Generally in Malaysia, if you want to copyright, you go to Malaysia MYIPO, Intellectual Property Organization. Okay, you have to go and copyright with them. Okay, so in this one, you create your license. Okay, so you go to creativecommons.org, so choose. Okay, come down to the back to the side. So you can bookmark this, okay. This will tell you in simple English. It's not going to give you legal jargon, anything. It just asks you some questions, okay. So one, allow adaptation of your work to be shared, which means I have my lecture note. Am I okay with sharing it? Yes or no? You just say yes, okay. If you click no, it will block. So it's basically yes. The next one is allow commercial use of your work, okay. So you don't want, right? Then you click no. Okay, so the license choice is entirely up to you. Okay, so there's another one called yes as long as others share it. Okay, I'll tell you when it applies. Now suppose I'm a researcher in political science and I'm delivering a lecture on political science, and in slide number 5 I said something which is against some political system, but in slide number 7 I actually corrected that whatever I said. I have given a justification for it. Now people can take your slides out of context, because they can say, oh, he said something against his anti-government, and then you end up in all sorts of legal trouble, right? So when you click on the word share alike, it means that you are sharing the entire content alike, as it is. Okay, so that means somebody has to watch the whole site. They cannot take it out of context. This actually happens with medical data. They will say, oh, ginger causes something, and something causes something, but it didn't see the other data. So then when it's taken out of context, it gives you wrong information. So then you have to use the as long as others share alike. Okay? So this generally we don't use for lectures unless they are very, very specific topics like medical data, the statistical data which needs to be seen in juxtaposition, contextual data. So then we now I click. Okay, go down to okay, now you got your license. This is your Creative Commons, this is you. So attribution and no commercial. So which means that if my student downloaded my lecture note, they will have to basically cite me. It's from Kenneth, and I cannot use it for making money, which means if you are teaching a Bloom's course, you cannot use this license, because it means that your content cannot be commercialized. If you are teaching a public university course like the rest of us, it doesn't generate income, we can use the non-commercial license. Okay, be careful with the usage of license.
What happens if someone does try to commercialize?
You can actually track them by the license, and you can take legal action against them.
I never
employ
a lawyer.
Oh,
the lawyer will bleed you dry.
You have to, you have legal recourse. At least you protect your content. Okay.
Are you entitled to free legal aid?
Freely?
As a public university lecturer, are you entitled to free legal aid?
Free legal aid? Pro bono,
if someone has contravened copyright.
No, we have our legal department. They will address your complaint. Okay. So you don't have to go to pro bono. You can actually use our legal department.
It could be very expensive if you do it individually.
Okay, to clarify that, doctor, the copyright basically is under the MIPO. We have different IP, so you have the copyright, patent, trademark, trade secret, etc. Right? Okay, so when you copyright with MIPO, anyone who wants to reuse your work has to go to MIPO and then to you, because you are the content creator, and they have to pay you the fee. Okay, in this case, they don't have to pay you a fee. So I mean, the safest bet is to go in for copyrights. But this is the next option, because if you want copyright your lecture, you have to organize them into a folder and make a book, and then you do it. It's entirely up to you. Okay, this is no payment. If you decide to copyright with MIPO, UMS will pay the MIPO fee after we review it to the committee. Okay, they will pay you, it's about 320 ringgit for MIPO for copyright. Okay. Trademark is cheaper, so to go patent, it's very expensive. UMS will pay. But you need to file it, and then it comes to our patent. Yeah, okay. This is another thing about copyright ACTA. Okay. If you see in your, there was a, when you see your HR online, you logged out, you see your other statement which came out, right, about copyrights and data. Okay, like this, like this. According to the Malaysian Copyright Act, okay, the ACTA, you can refer to it. All the, for example, if I'm contracted to the university to do a task, we are all lecturers contracted to the university, everything belongs to our organization. So the copyright belongs to the organization. Then your name, when you copyright it, will come with the university et al. So I have patents in UMS, but they are all UMS, Kenneth et al. So I am the et al. So the main holder of that patent or copyright is the university. Because they are paying my salary, so they own my patent. So as long as I am employed, they will own it. After I go out, it's different. So if there is any, that's what we have to discuss with the, you have to discuss with UPI. You have to discuss with UPI because your books are copyrighted, but you can sell your books. So you have to discuss with UPI regarding the profit sharing. I think you can contact Dr. Azalian. Azali is in charge of all these profit sharing and all that with UPI. Okay, that's what we do. So now this is your license. Let's see how you deploy it. So what you do now, you go, you scroll down. Okay, this is your basically your logo. You copy everything. Copy this. copy directly. If you have a web page, if you are using, for example, some of you use the web blog, blogger and all that, you can actually embed the license in your blog. Okay, so then you copy this, copy, and then insert it into your slide. Okay, preferably in the footer. Okay, you insert it and make sure it comes on each and every slide. It's carried in the slide itself. Okay, so then it's carried. So that's carried in your slide. Okay, okay. Now when you save this slide, okay, as a license slide, please save it as PDF. And you upload always as PDF. So of course nowadays you've got PDF tracker, right? You can track the PowerPoint, but that thing will leave an electronic trace in the system. Somebody cracked your file, there'll be an electronic metadata file which will track your change. So you can, okay, that's how your thing works. So you have your slide, you save it, okay? And if you want to really protect it, I mean truly make it CC, you deposit it into our OER account. Do you have an OER account, everyone here? Okay. You go to OER, when we teach you about OER Taklimat, we will teach you how to deposit your slide into OER. The moment you put it into OER, it's searchable on Google. You search all your slides being searchable on Google. And when they are searching on Google, if they download, you get cited as well. Okay? For example, if you are teaching something which is unique to Sabah, and someone cites it in another country because they are studying a similar kind of a ethnic system, or they will actually cite you. That citation will come back in your Google Scholar. Okay, it cites back. So this is actually a publication which is not peer reviewed, but it is still online in electronic format. Because each of your publications in your OER actually gets an electronic URL. Okay, it's electronically. So it's electronic publication online. So for example, if I go to the Kampung, I click pictures, I record what some work which I'm doing, I copy and paste, I do my CSR, prepare a four-page report, upload it into OER, it's actually considered as an output. Hasil, it's hasil already. So please use it. So all your content, see how much content you have, because the more content you have in the OER, the more your visibility increases. Okay. People will actually give you projects or collaboration from that OER repository. Okay, they search your name inside the system. Okay, this is ready. Okay, now your slide is there. Okay, go to another slide to save it. Save as PDF. Save as PDF. Just save it as CC. Okay, so save. Okay, now on slide number two. In slide number two, I want to use somebody's picture from online. Okay, I don't want to use copyrighted image. How do I find the image? I go back to Creative Commons. Go to Creative Commons. Okay, and then you look for Creative Commons. Wait for a while. Okay, sorry about the speed. It takes time to. Okay, you do a search in this image. Okay? Search CC images. So CC image. CC. Search for the image, look for coronavirus. If it is there, or just look for SARS or some other virus, I don't think there is SARS. Got a picture, okay, see SARS. Okay, see here, any SARS virus? Just put virus. Just put virus. Okay, this is the electron micrograph, okay, or the virus, okay, whatever, I don't know the technical, but you can see something. If you move your mouse over the image, Okay. If you mouse over the image, you'll see this CC, and what is the sign? I cannot see from here.
CC non-commercial,
right? So this is the image which you can use. For example, I want to prepare a small booklet for using on the Kotak Inaugural Airport. So I write some biosafety protocol, I use this image in the booklet. But I'm not selling it, I'm just giving it away free. So it's CC, I can use this image, okay? Now I want to put it. So Zul will copy this image, we copy it. You can see different images are different, okay? And you copy the image, okay? You copy the image, save images and upload into your slide. I'll show you how to use the. Actually, this is why, don't worry, earlier what happened, there was some stigma, you know, attached to copy and paste. This was, they said, oh, we are copying and pasting. And then, oh, your colleague said, oh, he copies and pastes. Actually, there's nothing about copy and pasting. You can reuse images, provided you can use the license. Don't be, there's always this stigma attached to copy and paste. Lecturer will always afraid. So the students say, I copy and paste. They will say, right, they talk on Facebook, oh, this cannot be always copy and paste. But don't worry about it. If it's a CC BY, it's copy and paste, it's legal copy and paste. And you're reusing. Why do you need to create the whole content again when it's already there? Okay, so you reuse it, remix and reshare. Okay, so that's your image inside, use it. Only thing, when you do it, you need to follow what is known as the TASL, T-A-S-L, which is the title, the author, the source, and the license attribution. Okay? If you see, if we correct our student thesis, they will always put the number and they will put the Sumba, right? In this one, the way you accredit, you credit the Sumba is different. Okay, so Zoom will copy the Sumba. So we go to the Sumba. Okay, so copy the Sumba. Okay, so this is the Sumba. So this is called copy. This you need to do every time. That's why when you prepare the first time lecture, is taking time, but at least you get the image. Okay, so copy. Okay, you attach the bar. Okay, below the slide, you can put here. So now we know. So this is the correct way. So you need to create the title. As you see the slide, you can see the title there. The title is the SARS virus by author, source, and then the license. Right? Title, author, source link. So that means anyone can click on that and they can go to the image. So the slide is set. So this is the way you attribute. Now see, suppose I want to prepare a lecture on coronavirus. For today, I can actually use all the images, all the content, site, WHO site, everything, and make my slide, and it's ready for students. Okay, it's as easy as, so that's how you remix content. Okay, so save this slide too. We use it as our image, as our content. So is it clear how you actually, basically you leverage your lectures with content? So, because today's world, right, is changed already. Today our identity is based on our digital footprint, or what we call digital fingerprint. The more license your content create and show on the web, the more your basically your reach is. Earlier what used to happen, people used to come to our class, they know you because of your class, and then the next generation of students, and then 10 years later your students came and they said, oh, we achieved something, and then you felt good. Okay, that's part of it. But today's world is different. You create content, you upload within maybe 30 days, you get downloads and analytics. That is the way the world has changed. So we use the system basically to improve our visibility. Okay, that's what. Okay, so that's it. So now we save it as PDF. Okay, so that's how. Okay, save. So we are done here with this system. So.